In this video you will learn how to create a slider in WordPress without any plugin. You can use this slider on your homepage in a full width format or in the columns of your posts. In designing slides, you can add titles. Or add a call to action button. Or you can just use the image. This image slider is very lightweight, and we have not used any JavaScript library in it. Go to the link in the description. Copy this PHP code. By clicking on the copy button, this code will be copied. On the WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, Theme File Editor, and open the functions.php file. As you can see, I am using the Bloxy child theme. You must create a child theme before making any changes to functions.php. Otherwise, the applied changes will be lost after each update. Watch video number 1 on the channel to learn how to make a child theme. Paste the code into the functions.php and update the file. Now open the page where you want to add image slider. Here we will add a full width slider to the top of this page. Add a cover block and design your first slide. Add an image to this block. In the overlay section, reduce the overlay opacity. If you don't need an overlay, set it to 0. Now add your desired text to this slide. Change the color of the text to your liking. Duplicate this cover block to make the next slide. Write your desired title. Change the color of the text to your liking. Add a button block to create a call to action button. Change the background of the button to your liking. Then change its background image. Duplicate this block once more to make the third slide. change the text, call to action button and background image to your liking. Now we have made 3 slides. Group these 3 slides together. Then assign it a class to it. Here we assign the slider class to this group. Publish the page and see the result. As you can see, the blocks are placed below each other. By adding our short code, we turn these blocks into sliders. Add a shortcode block. The name of our shortcode is slider, and it has 2 arguments, source and height. In the source, write the class name of the cover blocks group. And in the height, write the height for the slider. We publish the page and check the result. As you can see, the slider was created successfully. Now we change the height of the slider to 700 pixels. Slider height changed successfully. You can use other units for slider height. For example, if you want your slider to be full screen, change its height to 100 or 110 VH. That's it. If you do have any questions or comments about this, please put them below. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe. And I'll see you next time.